there must be 8-10 waterfalls here.
I know, right? You guys didn't believe me? And that Robinson family bought this land in the 1800s right off of King Kamehameha, 50 cents an acre. That's 52,000 square acres. It's worth billions. Same guys that owned the island here called Ni'ihau. We'll see you there in a little bit.
Where does the water come from?
Comes right off of Waialeale, wettest place on earth. There's two brothers. We got Bruce Robinson, he's the oldest, and then Keith. Bruce lives in the mountains here, he's a pretty humble guy, drives home most days, but he can do it a lot faster. That helicopter that was in Jurassic Park is actually his helicopter. And you can see his house. See that white dot in the mountains way off to our left out there? Only thing in the hills out there that's not green? It lives right there. Got a nice view.
How does he get in and out of there?
Either drives or flies, yeah. Remember, he's got the helicopter. And once we cross over that furthest ridge up ahead, we'll go right into Olakale. Olakale was a wedding gift to the Robinsons from a family called the Knudsens. They're the guys that created the tree tunnel. They own as far into the valley to the right, as you'll see here in a moment, all the way out towards the shoreline to our left.
What are their taxes a year?
This is protected land. Zero. You also can't do anything with it.
Kind of like forest crop in Wisconsin.
Right. See if you can spot Ni'ihau. Should be out on the horizon to our left. It'll look like a long, skinny island out there on the horizon. There's not many people that live out there anymore, too. It's all pure-blooded Hawaiians, maybe 70 people anymore. Remember, this is Olakale Valley, still private land.
Look at the coloration.
Great, isn't it? Kind of reminds me of Sedona sometimes. And it's not what you think. This is not Waimea. Not yet. We got to fly over the Robinson's property line first before we get to that, and I'll show you what that looks like. But the town that you'll notice way off to our left out there where the river goes out, that's Waimea Town out there, but you got to drive through the town before you get to the canyon. I'll show you the Robinson's property line. As you look ahead, there's three hills approaching in the distance. They're all really close to each other. They all parallel one another. On the third one up, as soon as we cross over that, we'll leave Robinson land and we'll go right into state land.
This kind of reminds me of Arizona.
Yeah, I think the same thing. And sometimes Waimea Canyon is called the Grand Canyon of the Pacific. This is the road just ahead of us here. Ends up going up that steep red hill to your right there. So you can look left or right, doesn't matter, as long as you look straight down. But as soon as we cross over this road right here, we're out of Robinson land and we're going into state land. In fact, it's passing below you right about there. Now we're on our way to Waimea Canyon.
That didn't look like a road.
It's not your normal road. Definitely more horseback. So out here in Waimea, west side, it's the first place you see the state tree. So if you notice these trees around here, they look like broccoli, that bright green color. That's a kukui nut tree. And so if you're familiar with something called a buckeye, it actually looks like a miniature version of that. coloration here is because Kauai is high in iron, that red color. It's also the oldest of the Hawaiian Islands. It's 5.5 million years old. Big Island's the youngest, 800,000 years old. They're all born from the same hotspot. Lots of trails around her too. Just in the canyon alone, there's 19 trails. The easiest trail to remember by name is called Canyon Trail. It goes right up to a waterfall called Waipo'o Falls. Same waterfall you see from the road when you drive up in the canyon.
We're breathing again.
So if you remember that Jurassic Falls we looked at not long ago, it was only about 400 feet high. The Waipo'o Falls we're going to look at in the mountains here, a little bit taller. We'll be approaching a 1,000-footer. Just look a little further into the mountains up here, just a couple more seconds, and here she comes. That is Waipo'o Falls. The trail is located on the left side of that upper waterfall, on the slope, right along the tree line. So little white dots you might see on that cliff up there, those are people. Now just so you know, that trail is only about 15 feet wide. There is no guardrail. It drops right off the edge. On the plus side, the trail is only 1.8 miles. All you guys should be able to knock this thing out, no problem.
Steve, I didn't forget about you. Didn't want to wake him. There you go.
Now you can't feel it up here, but the temperature is different. It was about 80 degrees at the heliport. We're now showing 67. This is why up in the mountains there's a reservoir I'll show you up here. You can go fishing for rainbow trout. We'll cross right over the main road for the canyon up here. It's called Highway 550. It's all paved, nice and twisty. Good chance, too, that you'll see a lot of white buildings along the shoreline once we do this. What it is Barking Sands Naval Base. It's the only military base on Kauai.
Where do you see a highway?
No, you can't see it. Not till we cross over the ridge, top of this cliff up here. Yep. There's the naval base way up ahead of us here. See all the white buildings? Then you'll see the road right below you, Betty. It's right on the edge of the cliff here. That's Highway 550 passing below you now. Yep. That reservoir you see sneaking up to our right called Pu'ulua, that's where you trout fish. Although if you notice a rectangular thing that floats around in the water down here sometimes, it's a little different. Looks like it is there. So what you're looking at right there, that's a seahorse petting zoo. No, that was a test. Sounded amazing, I know, but that's where they raise a trout. Just making sure you guys are switched on. Don't make this too easy on me.
We hear you.
Temperature 62 now. So it never snows here, but Maui and the Big Island, they're much higher elevations. It can snow there. This is all forest fire damage down to your left there, Steve. That happened about 5 years ago. A couple years back, they cleared out the dead trees, all eucalyptus. All of these tall, bushy trees you see out here, all eucalyptus.
What's the red roof over here?
Those are cabins over there, Helen. It's part of Coquet. You can rent them. It's not much to them. It's just a bed and a fireplace. That's really all you need. People that come up here and want to go hiking or fishing, or maybe you just want to sleep in the cold, it's a perfect place. There should be one.